I'm here with one of the best boxers in the United States. They compare him to Floyd Mayweather. They say Keyshawn Davis is the next Floyd, but here he is in Los Angeles. How you feeling?
What's up, man? I'm feeling good, man. I'm feeling great.
How do you like the comparisons? Like, you are the next Floyd. I hear it everywhere. Do you hear it?
I mainly hear it when I go overseas.
And what did they tell you?
They've just been saying, Keyshawn Davis, Floyd, Mayweather.
You're the big star of the Team USA to the Olympics.
Yes.
Hopefully there is an Olympics this year.
Yes.
Do you know if there is one or not? Or?
Yeah, they try to say they're going to make it for, they still shooting it for next year. Last thing I heard about it was they probably throw the vaccine in there, but we never know.
Well, hopefully you go, you win the gold, right, and then you turn pro and you take over boxing.
Yeah.
Are you ready?
Yeah, that's the plan, man.
Shakur's fighting this weekend. What do you think?
Shakur fight today, man. The dude he's fighting, I feel like he's a real 130.
19 knockouts, only two losses. He's good.
Right? Yeah, he's good. And he's a southpaw. And he's a boxer this time. You know, Shakur haven't fought a lot of boxers, so it's going to be an interesting fight, honestly.
Let's talk about this. There's a lot of things going on in boxing. You actually follow boxing. Rollies and Devin Haney are beefing. What do you think? You saw, I'm sure, the posts, I'm sure.
Nah, I ain't see that one.
There's not a lot of beefs in boxing today. That's one of them.
So Rollie trying to get him another fight, huh?
Rollie called him out to fight in the Mayweather undercard against Logan Paul.
Why not, huh?
Who do you like in that fight?
Of course I'm going with Devin Haney. Devin Haney, I feel like he's just a sharper fighter than Rollie. But, I mean, I feel like with a fight like that, it's a win-win situation for both of them.
And then Gervonta Davis wanted to fight in that undercard.
Yeah, he wanted to be co-main event, right?
Him and Jake Paul, I guess? How would he do with Jake? Well, he said it, but...
Right. He'll knock Jake out.
You think so? Jake's 200 pounds.
Jake not a boxer, though.
He looked good against Nate Robinson. Did you see that knockout?
He looked great against Nate Robinson.
Shout out to Nate Robinson, but Jake Paul got down. That was like knockout of the year type because he was out.
Yeah, definitely was one of the knockouts of the year. But take a knock him out.
When you heard that Mayweather's fighting Logan, or even his exhibition, what were you thinking?
He's an opportunist. You feel what I'm saying? I feel like Floyd, if it's an opportunity in front of him, he's just going to take it.
Why not? Make your money.
Right, exactly. And at the end of the day, he put up a performance for the fans, too. You know what I'm saying? For the people that probably never seen Floyd fight or just want to see him fight again.
It's a show.
Yeah, it's a show.
And if you're a young fighter in the undercard, you could just benefit. Imagine if your co-main event,
exactly,
all the eyeballs, the millions of millions. Logan Paul has 20 million, and he's going to, and Mayweather has 20 million.
Right.
When they talk trash each other in a press conference, it's going viral. Yeah. I don't care what they say to each other.
Tank, hopefully be on the undercard of that. He got, 2 million? You feel what I'm saying?
Two and a half already. He grew up half a million.
Yeah.
Speaking of Tank, Ryan Garcia is fighting Luke Campbell. Are you familiar with Luke? Have you ever studied him?
Oh, definitely.
Southpaw gold medalist.
Definitely.
What do you think?
That Lomachenko fight.
That was a good fight.
Yep.
You in England?
Yep.
How was that? Remember, how'd you end up there?
Remember, we was getting ready for the World Championships, and we was training in England. You feel what I'm saying? And they gave us tickets to go there.
And what did you see in that fight from Luke Campbell?
I seen Luke Campbell was actually a better boxer than what I thought he was. He hurt Lomachenko within the fight. And he lasted all 12 rounds, and I can see like the toughness in him. And I feel like when it comes down to him and Ryan Garcia, I think I was saying this with Lomachenko and Telefimo, but in this fight, with the experience difference, I think it really is going to play a part, because the size difference is not going to play a part. You feel what I'm saying? With the Lomachenko Telefimo, the size difference played a big part to where Lomachenko had to do more than he expected to do to get to Telefimo.
But Teofimo did his thing. He won that fight clearly, no question. And
definitely. But I feel like if the size was a little bit closer, Ellie, it would have been easier for Lomachenko.
But everybody wrote Teofimo off before the fight. Not a lot of people gave him a chance.
Yeah, I did.
You did, because you sparred him.
No, I didn't.
Oh, you didn't?
Yeah.
Okay.
I was with Lomachenko, honestly. He surprised me. But I was excited for that man, though. Like,
he did his thing.
He got a decision, I was excited for him. Like, he was one of my brothers or something.
Oh, but the good part is that he won. For him, he's now in the Hall of Fame, undisputed.
Yep.
He wants to fight the winner of Taylor and Ramirez. What do you think?
At 140?
Yeah, for all the belts. He's going to do one fight at 35 and then move up.
Is he going to move up for sure, or he's going to do like a Tank situation at 30, 35?
No, I think he's going to do one fight at 35, maybe in Australia against Kambosos, George Kambosos, and then 140.
If he fight Ramirez, I feel like him and Josh Taylor would be a better fight than him and Ramirez. I feel like him and Ramirez would be like a Shakur Stevenson, Joette Gonzalez fight. like an easy, I feel like Teofimo will box him easy. I don't think he'll knock him out, but just a clean box with him and Ramirez. Him and Josh Taylor, I feel like it'll be more tactical, and they got to set up the big shots, you feel what I'm saying, to land flush and to get that, you know, that edge over each round. You feel what I'm saying? So I think that Josh Taylor fight will be a better fight for him, more exciting fight.
Right now, what's your record in the amateurs? Not that amateur records matter, but...
Right. I got about, let's say about 12 to 14 losses, and I probably won about 150.
That's crazy. And we know in the amateurs, losses are not always losses. There's a lot of controversy. I've been there, I mean, where the judges live watching a Laker game and like, how do you score the fight? You're not even paying. And you know, they don't get paid, so respect to them, but yeah, we know. Yeah. But 150 wins, very few losses. Yeah. The plan is to go to the Olympics and then turn pro.
Yeah.
From the... I'm sorry.
And then, I mean, with our Americans records, like, we be basing our records off of when we was like 9 years old, 10 years old and stuff like that. A lot of these European records be based off their elite status, their elite records, so it's a real record. You feel what I'm saying? So it be different. Like, the records nowadays doesn't matter at all.
So you could be 100 and 0 with 100 knockouts in amateurs. It don't matter. It's who you fought.
Right.
How you fought.
Look at Lomachenko. He got one loss in amateurs and two losses in pros.
It's true. You feel what I'm Clarissa saying? Shield, one loss in amateurs, but she's a two-time gold medalist, and she's a three. Now she's getting into MMA. She's still boxing. Have you been watching some of that?
The MMA on her Instagram? Yeah.
Shout out to Clarissa.
I was DMing her a few months back before she started posting about it. I asked her, and I said, I ain't gonna say nothing, Clarissa, but are you really looking forward to doing the other side of, you know, combat sports? She was like, yeah, Keyshawn, man, I'm looking forward to actually, I'm gonna start next year. And she actually started this year, so I mean,
she was John Jones.
She was having the balls to do that, man.
Holly Holm, she's learning from the best, but she's still gonna box.
Oh, yeah, I was wondering about that. She got a good coach, right?
Like, I think she's fighting February in boxing. Yeah, she has, like, one of her best in MMA. And in May, she's going to do MMA. And I think it's great for her career because she's going to bring all the MMA fans to boxing and the boxing fans
to MMA. Yeah. And I hope she'd be the biggest female athlete in history.
I don't see how not.
I don't see how
not. I said she has one loss in amateurs, and the girl is avoiding her in the pros.
Yeah, she is. She definitely is.
We know what would happen if they fought.
Oh, yeah.
Shakur said that Loma didn't show heart against Teofimo. And
he didn't
that
show heart?
He said, that's what Shakur, I saw an interview with ESPN, I think. How would Shakur do with Loma if they fight? Because it looks like that's building up that fight right now.
I think, if they have a fight right now, I think Shakur will outbox Loma. 12 rounds for sure. I think, honestly, what I think personally, I think Lomachenko is on his way out. All the guys he done beat was kind of like older guys. The new generation is a different level, and I don't think Lomachenko can hang with these younger guys anymore. I think Shakur outboxes him 12 rounds straight. Easy, easy fight, honestly.
Out of all the biggest names in boxing, how old are you now, by the way?
21.
You're just a baby. You're 21. Who have you shared the ring with? Who have you sparred from the big names that everybody watching knows?
I sparred Teofimo Lopez. Shouts out to Teofimo, man. Great fighter. Terrence Crawford. Shouts out to Terrence Crawford, man.
How was that, by the way?
That shit was crazy. Like, I don't know, man. That shit was crazy, man.
Why? It was like looking experience. In the mirror almost?
Yeah, honestly. And then it was definitely like looking in the mirror.
He's a very smart fighter.
Switch. You feel what I'm saying? So it was like I was fighting two different people. You feel what I'm saying? So that was crazy. And then
but it's a great experience for you. None of your opponents will be Terrence Crawford.
Nah, hell nah. Not Shakur Stevens. I mean, a lot of people, but...
Okay, Tank. Tell me about sparring Tank, because Tank power is out of this world.
Yeah, definitely.
You were not in there to say, hit me, let me taste it. No,
Hell no.
But you can see those punches, and he's very fast, too.
Yeah, definitely. And he got great reaction time. He got great legs to get him out the way of certain punches. Sometimes I would think I was going to hit him, but he'd get out the way so fast and so neatly that it was like you just had to respect it, like the talent was there.
Him and Ryan might fight next year, yeah.
For real?
Yep.
They hyping that up?
Well, if Ryan beats Luke Campbell, his next fight, I think, is Tank.
For real? So, in Shakur's next big fight is Jamel Herron and what's his name?
Correct, Frampton. Carl Frampton winner.
Frampton. And they supposed to fight when?
March, I think. I don't know. Maybe earlier because I see Jamel Herron training like crazy. But maybe he always trains. He always has an 8-pack. That's a good fight.
Yeah, who you got out of that Shakur and Jamel, or Shakur and Frampton?
It's hard to go against Shakur.
Yeah.
But we'll see. I will always say this is my slogan: the fans are the winners.
Yeah.
But Shakur is a special talent.
Yeah.
They say that a great fighter is like Halley's Comet. Once in 70 years, it flies over the earth.
Yeah.
That's how a great fighter is. Shakur is great.
Yeah.
Frampton's great. Jermell Herring's a champion. You can't disrespect the champion.
Right.
But Shakur is just something different. He smiles. He seems this. But in the ring, different story.
Yeah.
What did you take from sparring Crawford, just from the experience?
What did I take from sparring Crawford? When I was sparring him, he was using more mental than the physical. And back in the day, this was when I was on my way to the Pan American Games. So this is like 19-year-old KEYSHAWN, 21 now. He was using more mental than physical. And I was watching, as I was sparring him, I was watching him and I was actually seeing him. And I was just trying to like, you know, just trying to use the physical part. So I took that and I kept that in my head and I started slowing my game down to where I want to throw a punch unless that punch is open or, you know, just slowing down and picking shots. And I took that with me and just kept progressing off of it.
It's chess, not checkers. It's a thinking man's game.
Right,
and
exactly.
You can't lose focus for 1 second. If you zone out.
Right. Like, I can say, I ain't gonna lie, man. I can say that's one guy that was like, and these, a lot of guys don't do this to me, but that was one guy that respected that I was an amateur. You feel what I'm saying?
But everybody else take you easy, and then it bites him in the ass.
Right, exactly. Yeah. Like, he actually respected it all the way through. So that's what really told me, like, okay, this guy, this
he knows.
Grown man,
he knows boxing.
A different level. Yeah.
But everywhere I go, when I mention your name to people, they all say, Elie, this guy's going to take over boxing. You may not hear it here because you're so training all the time, but your reputation is already like you're going to take over the sport. It's up to you to stick with it and do it. But he probably heard the same thing, and he knew it. He probably saw you train.
Yeah.
How about him and Crawford? Is that the fight you want to see?
Who and Crawford?
Crawford and Spence.
Definitely. But, and I love Errol Spence. And I don't know if Errol Spence is going to rock with me after this, though. Not after this, but I'm just saying, like, I think Terrence Crawford going to win that fight, man. Just talking boxing. You feel what I'm saying? Like, I always said I felt like Terrence Crawford had the better boxing ability. But I still was giving Errol Spence a chance because, of course, the size difference. And he can fight also.
They're both undefeated.
You feel what I'm saying? But I'm basing off the last performances. I got Terrence Crawford.
But Kelberg, I thought Kelberg got hit. And it looked like, listen, I've never been hit by Crawford. But the way Crawford landed on him, it looked like he got hit by a sledgehammer. He spinned around 3 times. And after the fight, he was so happy it was over. You see him after the fight, like, hey, let's take a picture.
Yeah, yeah.
It's not like he went straight to the hospital. Yeah. But again, Crawford did what he had to do. You don't get paid for overtime. You could smoke someone, smoke him.
Yeah.
And Earl could have fought me, could have fought you, and we would understand. Like, I'm saying, he had the crash, and he went there, and Danny was trying to knock his head to the third row with, did you see the fight?
Yeah, I seen it.
And he did good.
Yeah.
So it's a great fight.
The opponent was a difference. But this is all I'm saying, Elie. People were saying Terrence Crawford's strength, he's small, he's weak. It showed that man can, he's a real 147.
Nah, he's one of the best pound-for-pound fighters.
Yeah, he is.
He's tall, he's lengthy.
So people can't have that Lomachenko and Teofimo matchup difference no more. You feel what I'm saying? This is a real 147 matchup right here. And people can't say Errol Spence is going to win because he's bigger, he's stronger anymore. Like, that's out the window. And that's like one of the biggest reasons I was giving Errol Spence to win. You feel what I'm saying?
Okay. Pacquiao, who do you want to see him fight? Do you want to see him fight Spence, Crawford, or Conor McGregor? Or Mikey? I think those are the four names that are floating.
I want to see Pacquiao fight Errol Spence.
Why?
Because the styles make fights.
Southpaw?
Yeah, that too. I didn't realize that.
Yeah, but Spence could bang, he could box. Pacquiao's always come forward and he's gonna bring a lot of explosiveness.
Right.
But we've seen Spence do both.
Yeah, I guess a smaller fighter. But yeah, he definitely did both. But I feel like if he fight Pacquiao's gonna bring the fight. So he probably is going to, he probably might do a mixture of both though. Because he can box Pacquiao, I can see. And I can see him walking Pacquiao down too. You feel what I'm saying? So it depends. It's up to Spence how he want to fight Pacquiao.
What makes you good as a fighter? What do you think they attribute? Is it your speed, your power, your intelligence? Is it a little bit of everything? Is it your footwork? Is it your mental game? Do you talk trash too when you fight, spar?
Yeah.
Does that, you get in people's head? You get them rattled up? They want to knock you out?
Yeah. And that's all I do. I just get into their head. I don't take nothing personal.
But what is it, boxing-wise? Like, you have to be very talented to get to where you are. What is it?
Well, people tell me it's my speed. What I think it is, honestly, I think it's my mental. I got a very, very good mentality. Like, I can talk trash to the guys that talk trash and get into their head type of thing. Or I can box the boxer, or I can out-punch the puncher. Or if I didn't do it that day, I'd go back and work on that. To out-punch the puncher. You feel what I'm saying? Like, it's just my mentality on, if I'm going to do it, I'm going to do it. And I'm not going to let nobody stop me from doing it. And I just convert all of that into fighting. You feel what I'm saying? And so when I get into the ring, it just second nature for the most part.
But it's not an easy sport. ESPN did a list of the 50 most difficult sports. Boxing was number one. I think MMA is number two, wrestling three. Dang. It's hard to make weight. It's hard to get punched. Everybody gets punched at some point. And B, it's hard to always be disciplined. What keeps you so disciplined in a sport where what you eat, how you live? I always see your lives and I always see your Instagram. You're always training.
Yeah, definitely. Coronavirus definitely tested my discipline, tested my patience to the next level. Didn't fight in a year. The Olympic trials was this year, like this week last year.
Wow.
So it's been a whole year and counting. So it's definitely testing my patience and testing my discipline. How do I do it? I just stay around energy like this. Around professional camps. My brother about to fight on NBC.
We're going to introduce him in a second.
Right. He about to fight on NBC Sports.
What's his name? Tell people his name.
Kelvin Davis, man. Shout out my brother, my big brother, Kelvin Davis.
He's big physically, too. He's like 6'5", right?
6'5", 140, man.
140. He's like Klitschko in the 140 division.
Yeah, definitely.
What makes him good as a fighter?
What makes him good? He's a southpaw, fast, lengthy fighter.
You have a sparring?
Definitely.
Do you guys get heated sparring?
I get mad because I got a temper, so I be getting mad sometimes.
Some moms don't let their son spar because someone's going to win the sparring. Someone's going to get hit. You don't play boxing, as you know.
Yeah, definitely.
But
definitely.
It's good work, and and I don't care if you're facing a guy 5'1 or 6'1, you got to prepare for every situation.
Oh, yeah, hell yeah.
KEYSHAWN, who else is on the Olympic team that you're friends with?
Shout out to Bruce Carrington, Shushu. Shout out to Delonte Johnson, Tiger. Shout out to Raheem Gonzalez. Shout out to O'Shea Jones, Rashida Ellis.
Everybody.
Yeah, shout out to the whole USA Boxing team USA, man.
Some of the guys already turned pro. The alternates, two of them turned pro already. They didn't want to wait for the Olympics.
Yes, Charlie
David.
Sheehy,
so three.
David.
The kid from Milwaukee.
Javier.
Yep.
Martinez. Yeah, they all fighting on television.
That's why I asked you. Hold on. Okay, KEYSHAWN Davis, introduce who's in the ring right now.
Oh, this is my big brother, Kelvin Davis, man.
Boxing sensation. I see he was a team member of Team USA, right?
Yup.
And his pro debut, what can we expect from him on his pro debut? He's fighting on NBC Sports.
You can expect like a first round knockout for real, what I expect, honestly.
To me, he reminds me of Paul Williams because of the size, but who do people compare him to? Like style-wise.
When Cadell Whitaker went live, Cadell loved him.
And I love him?
I was thinking the same thing.
You're thinking of Paul Williams?
Paul Williams.
That's a big compliment.
I kind of say Pernell sometimes.
Are you that slick?
Huh?
You can't be touched?
Nah, I can't be touched, man. Sorry, Paul.
They could call you the ghost. You just appear. Coach, you know who Brian Scalabrine is from the Boston Celtics?
No, but I bet I look like
him. You guys look like twins separated at birth.
Coach.
What can you tell us about him, Coach?
Huh?
Tell us about him.
Oh, he's good. Southpaw, tall, slick, yeah, a lot of power.
A lot of power and turning pro. How excited are you?
I'm very excited, man. I'm ready to get my feet wet in this pro game, man. I've been amateur for like 11 years now. Trying to get my career.
You're ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
What can you tell us about your brother, KEYSHAWN Davis?
Man, greatest amateur in the world, man, right now.
They say he's the next Floyd.
Yeah, next Floyd, man. He going for that gold medal. That's the start. And after that, he's taking over the pro game.
Okay, so if all of you guys are at home and I break in, who's going to kick my ass the worst?
Probably the smallest one.
Yeah, we're going to work your way up. From your baby brother.
Everybody.
We might just all get you at one time.
Now, you guys are from Virginia, right?
Yeah, both.
North Virginia. Not a lot of boxers come out of there.
Yeah,
Sweepy, of course, but besides him?
Yeah.
Just you?
Yeah.
And what are they working on now?
Head movement, moving his feet at the same time, working mainly defense.
So fans are going to get a treat.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, @EliSeckbach.